Good afternoon, everyone. Europe, Arctic air this early in the season. This chart should scare you with the heat and the cold separated, and they're both extremes at 20 degrees either way. This is how much lightning down in the Mediterranean. And let's take a stroll through Rome. This is how much hail came down associated with this front. Atmospheric compression event, in case you're wondering what it is. Spain receiving 15 inches of rain in just a day. Italy blanketed with snows. Tornadoes in Cyprus. And this is how much snow you can expect moving forward through the end of the month. And North America, you're next. And how prepared are you for emergencies like this where you may be stranded or not able to reach your stores? I've teamed up with My Patriot Supply to bring you emergency food kits, long-term food storage, the Adapt 2030 links below in the description box. And join me for Mini Ice Age Conversations podcast number 126, Formation of the Equatorial Vortex, a new heat pattern on our planet. This is exactly what this video is about, these jet streams going out of flow, creating these new vortices around our planet. Start you off over here, Western Europe, North Africa, UK. Arctic air on tap for the rest of the month. And when I say that, it's going to be literally 20 to 25 degrees Celsius below normal temperatures, with extremes colliding on the other side of 20 or so degrees Celsius above normal. So these jet streams are colliding in on each other. They're in the wrong places. These vortices are forming around our planet, and they're just going to intensify from this point forward. Now, case in point, I'm going to walk you through the next week here so you can see how this climate chaos is going to ensue. Currently, North Africa, the blue below, and up into Scandinavian countries as well, a little bit below normal, 4 to 5 degrees Celsius over the UK, warmer, but then it flips in a single day. Turns cold, that purple, we're looking somewhere around 16 to 20 degrees below normal. And as it continues to roll out through the rest of the week, below the averages as this pushes forward. Now you can see these two colliding, hot and cold masses. What do you think is going to happen along that line? We're already seeing some massive events, 6 months worth of rain in just a day, massive hailstorms, lightning, unbelievable flooding, and absolutely terrifying weather. And this is the new norm for our planet moving forward as the grand solar minimum intensifies. But when you see a chart like this, it really should stop your heartbeat for a few seconds here, because this is not normal at all. This is absolutely something that we have not seen. That dark gray on the right, 16 to 20 Celsius above normal. That pink and purple on the left, 16 to 20 degrees Celsius below normal temperatures. And people have been saying the UK has been really mild for these last few winters. Well, that stops right now. This is the snow forecast going out through the next few days. Scotland, Wales up there, going to get some snow. Now remember, 2010, I'm going to take you a little bit into the Wayback Machine here. We're going to drop back 8 years. Temperatures drop minus 14 Celsius. You have to wonder, what kind of winter? Are we going to see these canals freeze again this year? I'm going to say yes. Taking a look at the snowfall expected out to the rest of the month here, looking at some significant snowfalls across Europe, east, west, and even look at Morocco down there. Just like last year, all-time record snows. Well, the snows have begun in Italy. This is what's coming down, continues to come down. Abruzzo, we've seen record snowfalls for the last 2 years in this location. Peg it on your map. Look for record snowfalls again this year. But when you see these colliding air masses with such temperature differences, astounding what is happening with our jet streams and the grand solar minimum mix-ups. Huge amount of lightning is an understatement. This is going to amplify from here. Look for 300, 400,000 strikes as these storms and fronts collide with each other. Now, just as an example, Cyprus, not an area you would ever think tornadoes forming, but here we go, an EF3 tornado, Cyprus. Now, accompanied with these strange winds, massive atmospheric compression event over Spain. You see how it's just that consolidated area that rings out of the sky there in the front, dropping 15 inches of rain in just a day. So the cities can't even handle this. It's totally inundated, overwhelmed. And were you ever looking along riverbanks and some of these areas that have been paved over a lot, you're starting to see flash floods ripping through southern Spain here. This is it. This is the intensification of the Grand Solar Minimum. Waterfalls through the cities. Over in Italy, roadways. This is taken off of a bus on a live video. I've linked everything below so you can back check. Really interesting videos coming out. But you don't expect this in Rome. This is Rome that these images are taken in here with the hailstorms. Wide out for you a little bit. And other places around in Rome as well. Look how deep that hail is. That's 1 to 2 feet deep. So much, in fact, that it started to roll down escalators in shopping malls in Rome. It started initially with several inches of hail, and then it turned into flooded roads with hail. And then by the end of the evening, there were rescues, people calling for help, and parts of the city turned into this icy nightmare. Thanks for watching. Hope you got something out of the video. I did my best to explain how these new equatorial vortex are going to be combining with the Arctic vortex in episode number 126 of Mini Ice Age Conversations. The time is here. It's happening now. This is our weather, and you need to understand what it is so you can make wise choices, not panicked choices moving forward. I encourage you to watch it, and thank you so much for spending your time checking out the video.